Hey everyone.
As you all know, there are things that I like to say, and sometimes it comes across a little rude. Look, it is what it is. If you're not used to it by now, then you need to find somewhere else to get your entertainment, because sometimes I can be rude, sometimes I can be a smartass, and sometimes I say some shit that probably shouldn't have ever been said. But fuck it, it is what it is. So these are the top 20 things that I would like to say if I got the chance to meet these people. Miley, baby, it's time for you to go sit your little ass down somewhere. I'm tired of you. Oh, Lindsay, I'm surprised you're still alive. How much longer can you keep me surprised? Gucci, yo, man, what the fuck are you saying? I don't know what the fuck you be saying half the time. To all of the American Idol judges, please don't come back. I'm done. Last season was enough. It was like a slow, torturous death at the hands of four very, very annoying people. Good luck, Simon. Everything you do. Good luck, Simon. Kara, I hope that the show doesn't come on next year, because I'm done with you. You need to go write your songs and leave us alone. Ellen, I love you. You're so inspirational. I love you so much. But no, please, no. It has to end. Last season has to be it. I can't take anymore. Randy, yeah, dog. No, shut up. Go back on tour with the Jacksons. They need the money. Please. Number five. Kiefer Sutherland. Yo, 24 series finale. If I didn't watch that shit on regular TV, I'd be asking you for my money back. I need a movie. After that shit, come on. I need a movie. And the movie better be damn near done by this point, because I know you ain't been doing shit else. This was a very good couple of years. Whitney Houston. Whitney, baby, you know what? Represent Jersey all day. Yeah. I'm so glad that crack is finally whack for real. I'ma need you to give up singing just like you gave up on the crack. Your blood-curdling yodel and I Look to You made me feel like I was being stalked. Maybe it's time to consult on CDs or be on a reality show where you like a judge or some shit. But don't do it on American Idol. The cast of the Jersey Shore, some of my favorite people. I just want to say to you, thank you so much for being yourselves. You make me so proud to be black. There are no black people on the Jersey Shore. It's just y'all representing. Soulja Boy, I need you to go away now. Or make better music. One or the other has to happen. You can't continue on this path. I know you made a whole lot of money. And you give to charity and you do your thing. You a young boy. Go do what you gotta do, young boy. But don't make any more music. Not until you know how to make music, because I'm tired of it. No more music for a while, for a little while. Stay in your corner, young man. Jovan, you like a dude that's always up to something, but you keep a smile on your face. I can respect that. This motherfucker be smiling all the time. He just be like, ha ha ha. Smilingest vice president ever. Rock on, Jovan. Number 10, I would like to say to Aaron Magruder, I love the fucking Boondocks, yo. Even when it was a comic strip, I love that shit. Huey and Riley are the new Malcolm and P. Diddy. Such a fucking great show. Just keep doing it. It's a reality check. I love it. Keep it going. I love it. All of the Bravo Housewives, if you're not married, you need to return the script and take your ass down to the unemployment line, because you're disqualified. You can't be a housewife if you're not married. So why the fuck are you on a show about housewives? It doesn't make any sense to Ben Rock. It doesn't make sense to anyone, but it's still very entertaining. You bros are crazy as cat shit, and I love it. It's great TV. Keep it coming, bitches. Keep it coming. Vanna White, yo man, it's been like 1,000 years, and you still turning letters, and they still keep you fly as shit. You come out in these dresses to turn letters. You've been doing it for so long, I just had to say, yo, just keep doing it. I want to see Vanna White, 80 years old, with a fucking walker, like, hold on. Doom! That's what I want to see. This one is for Lady Gaga. Yo, I don't know what kind of trip you're trying to take us on, but I like you. And so does Grace Jones, who we all know you Swagger Jack. It's cool though, you know what I mean? Because everybody take influence from somebody else. But don't try to fool us into thinking that you're doing shit Grace ain't do back in the fucking 70s. When Grace was a wild bitch. That's strange. Hey, she got naked and was like, well, you're gonna fuck me. You ain't special, bitch. Don't think you doing some new shit. Because Grace gonna come through with a cane and knock you the fuck out. She gangsta like that. She crazy. But pay homage. Ask her to be on your next CD. She won't fuck you up. Trey Songz, just keep your shirt off, man. Because this shit is working. Everyone loves it. Anybody tries to give you a shirt, you should have been assassinated. No shirts for you, Trey. That's your whole career right there. Number 15, another very important one. Erykah Badu. Can I get a motherfucking window seat? I don't want to be bothered with nobody either. I feel you. Put me near the window and just pray that the people that get on the bus are looking at you like, I don't want to sit next to this motherfucker and move to the back. If you keep a constant scowl on your face, you can make anybody leave you the fuck alone. I mean, I can do it. Don't nobody want to fuck with that? I love that song. I love your CD. I saw you in concert. I want a window seat on Erykah's tour bus. Fuck that shit. The Fox 29 Good Day Philadelphia staff. Every morning, my TV wakes me up, and there you are, smiling, happy. Oh God, it annoys me so much, but it makes me wake up because I know I have to get up and go to work and be productive and all those good things that keep bringing money to the table. Hey, you know, you're not bad looking people. If you were like ugly, we'd probably just turn the TV off. You guys look like you just prepared for the day. Thank you, Fox 29, Good Day Philadelphia staff, for waking me up every morning. Gordon Ramsay, the dude from Hell's Kitchen, somebody's going to straight stab you. I'm waiting for it to happen because I know somebody's going to just snap and be like, fuck this TV show, and like throw a blender at you or some shit. Why you gotta be so mean? You a fucking chef. Chefs are supposed to be jolly motherfuckers that cut up carrots and make salads and shit. You cursing motherfuckers out and making them wet themselves? Dog, you're a chef. Calm down. Be happy. Make a salad. Toss a salad. Do what you gotta do to calm the fuck down. MediaTakeout.com. I go to your website and just feel so dirty after I read that shit, because I don't know if it's true or not, but so fucking dirty. Thank you. You make my mornings whorish. Thank you so much. Centric, the new station that's on everyone's lips. I see that you've been running a whole lot of old shows from back in the day. I can only watch the A-Team and Miami Vice, but so many times before I realized, hey, I'm not 8. What the fuck is this? You need some writers? Saying, I'm just putting it out there. I do write, and daddy needs a couple things that can't get right now. Please consider me. Number 20, I think the most important out of all of these rantings, President Barack Obama. I know it's been very difficult for this past year and a half. I know you've been fighting an uphill battle every day. It's a whole lot going on in the world right now. I just want to say that I think that you are doing a hell of a job. And I know there are a lot of people out there who probably don't think you're doing a good job. And there are some people who think you're doing an alright job. I know it can't be easy running this country. I think you handled the job with a whole lot of grace and tact. We haven't really been shown class in the White House for a very long time. And it's nice to actually see somebody who can be classy, but at the same time do whatever he got to make the job better for himself and better for the country, and just do what he got to do. So that's all I wanted to say. Check out www.blogtalkradio.com/hotwire, where you can listen to the Liquor Cabinet on Thursday nights and the Rated R Show on Tuesday nights. Hope you like this video. If you laughed, give me $1 for every time you laugh, because I need the money. That's fucking with you. Here's.